Hi everyone. Well, you never know what the weather's going to be like here in Southern California. We can be in between fall and summer, which is kind of what we're like right now. So I've actually got some hot weather crops or summer crops that I'm trying here on my cement area by my fountain in hopes that we might get a burst of hot weather and get some growth. I planted some cucumbers here. And I'll show you a close-up, but they're just starting to come up. Imagine that, cucumbers. And here it is, the middle of October. And I actually have a watermelon going in a pot. I just threw some seeds in a pot just to see what for the heck of it would do. And I know it's not gonna get real deep roots in the pot, but I actually have a little baby watermelon right here, but there's some tooth marks on it. And we've been having some problems in the garden, and hopefully it won't get this little baby watermelon. Even if it doesn't get very big, it'll be kind of interesting just to see what it does. But I got lots of blooms here on this watermelon too. So it'll be interesting to see what happens. And then right here, I planted in a pot some squash, which I'm actually getting little baby squash on here, believe it or not. It's a lemon squash. Not doing too bad in here. Now these plants might not get that big, but it's a fun little experiment to try. And if I get a couple of tiny little things, I'll be happy. But that's not what we're talking about today. Today, I'm actually gonna be planting some broccoli, which, it's a cool weather crop, so I'm trying to grow both right now. But I've got some broccoli seedlings here and some cauliflower actually. And one thing I'm really trying to do is eat more of a plant-based diet and get more of my protein from plants. And some people say there's no protein in plants, but actually there is. Did you know that, let me find a little broccoli seedling here. Broccoli, actually 45% of broccoli is protein. Okay, so when you eat a piece of broccoli, you're getting 45% of it in protein, as opposed to chicken, which has only 23%. Now, I'm not a vegetarian, but just trying to grow more plants that are protein-based or have a lot of protein in them. So broccoli and cauliflower are really good for that. And I'm actually, over the next few weeks, gonna be taking out some of these things here in this planter, leaving some peppers, and I actually have a tomato plant going on over there that I'm gonna leave. But some spots like this that are empty where I already have drip irrigation in place, I'm gonna be planting some broccoli and cauliflower. So I want to make it as simple as possible for myself and plant where I already have irrigation in place, because I don't want to have to worry about irrigation twice a year in the springtime and in the fall time. So try and just do it where I don't have to move a lot around. So I'm just loosening up the soil here, and it's actually pretty dry. I have little teeny tiny quarter inch drip irrigation soaker hoses in here, which do the job when you have a lot to water, but they don't really seem to get very saturated. And as you guys well know, we are in a drought, so I'm very limited as to what I can water. So I'm gonna loosen the soil up. It's already pretty loose. I had some, I think I had a chard plant in here before that just kind of finally bit the dust. So I went ahead and pulled it out, and that loosened the soil up really nicely. Just gonna add some compost to it, and this is my very own homemade grass clipping compost. And actually, guys, I dug down deep to get this. This is nice, fine stuff. Look at that. It's wonderful. There's not a lot of wood chips in there. The top of my pile tends to get a little woody because I don't screen it. So I just dug down in deep, got some of this stuff. It's looking really, really good. I'm gonna mix that in here, and I'm gonna plant myself a little broccoli seedling. Now, I started these indoors. I'm thinking, let's see if I wrote the date on here. Of course I forgot to write the date, but I'm thinking maybe 4 weeks ago. Okay, I kept them inside for a couple weeks till they started to sprout. Then once the weather got a little bit cooler, I put them outdoors. I like to start them in the Jiffy peat pellets. I always take this little netting off because it really does restrict the roots, whether or not they say you can leave it on. I never do. And this is looking pretty good. It's definitely ready to be planted. It's been sitting outdoors on my deck for a couple of weeks now in the sun. I'm just gonna dig down deep here. Don't wanna dig it in too deep, but it should be a good little spot here for this broccoli seedling. Nice sunny spot. This is the best spot in my yard in the wintertime to plant things, because the center of the yard gets the most sun. Now, I live on a hill facing north, so the hill really does get shaded by the house by probably 1 or 2 o'clock in the afternoon. It's about 2 o'clock right now, and my hill is almost completely shaded. So it's really hard for me to grow a lot there during the winter time that will produce much. But here in the fire pit fountain, or the fire pit planter as we call it, the fountain planter, this spot gets full sun for most of the day. So there, I got my little broccoli seedling planted. I'll bring you in close and show you that. And I'm also going to plant a cauliflower. Now, unfortunately in here, I have broccoli, I have cauliflower, which if you notice this tag, it's floating around loose in my tray. So unfortunately I got them mixed up. So pretty sure this one's broccoli that I just planted, but I'm hoping this one looks a little bit different. So I'm hoping that this one's cauliflower. Hard to tell when they're so little, but I'm going to plant this one right in the corner. I'm going to plant them maybe a foot or so apart because broccoli plants can get pretty large. I've never grown cauliflower before, so I'm not sure how big these plants get, but basically I'm going to follow pretty much the same procedure. Now I had a pepper plant in here. As you can see, I've got this little pole. So actually I'm probably going to take that out for now. My pepper plant died on me. This pepper plant lived for 2 years, believe it or not, and produced these peppers here for about 2 years, but it finally bit the dust. So we're going to do the same thing, just dig down, loosen up the soil so the roots have a nice loose soil to grow in. And got some good drip irrigation lines in here. Oh, and a little ladybug. I have had a lot of aphid problems this year, so I've definitely seen more ladybugs in the garden trying to get rid of those aphids. Sometimes I have to help the ladybug out a little bit with some neem oil or some spray right on the leaves to get rid of the aphids. Okay, I'm gonna get some compost in here. Just mix it in so this plant has a good start. Oh, and I meant to throw some Epsom salt, my favorite garden fertilizer. Super cheap. Mix it around. Get this grub out of here. I used to find grubs in my compost. I'm gonna go ahead and get the cauliflower planted. Cauliflower and broccoli like the cooler weather. Well, cooler for us, about 75 degrees or so, which is perfect. In the wintertime, we rarely get frost here in Southern California. So these guys should do really, really well here in the wintertime. So there you go, a couple of cool weather crops, a couple of crops that are a great source of plant protein. And hopefully they're gonna take off real soon. The weather will stay cool, I hope, and they're gonna do real well. And before too long, we'll be harvesting some broccoli and cauliflower. So thanks a lot for watching, guys. Oh, and let me know what you're planting for cool weather crops. Love to hear what things are like in your neck of the woods. All right, thanks a lot for watching, guys. And don't forget to check out our vlog channel. We'll put a link down below here. All kinds of interesting behind the scenes stuff going on that we're showing you from our daily lives that you're not going to see here on the Garden Channel. So go check it out. All right, guys, hope we see you over on the vlog too. See you later. Bye-bye.